This is a WMUR Commitment 2020 special in partnership with the New Hampshire Institute of Politics. Conversation with the candidate. Tonight, Mayor Wayne Messam.
Good evening and welcome to our Conversation with the Candidate series. I'm Adam Sexton and our guest this evening is the mayor of Miramar, Florida, Wayne Messam. Tonight we'll be getting to know Mayor Messam and where he stands on key issues. At the start of our show, I'll be asking the candidate some questions, and then after a break, we'll have our studio audience ask their questions in a town hall format. But before we begin with that, let's take a quick look at the candidate's biography.
Wayne Messam was born in rural Pahokee, Florida in 1974. He grew up in South Bay, a first-generation American. His parents emigrated from Jamaica. After graduating from Glades Central High School, he went to Florida State University on a full football scholarship and was a starting wide receiver playing for Coach Bobby Bowden on the 1993 National Championship team. The FSU Black Alumni Association named him Student of the Year in 1996, and Messam graduated with a Bachelor's in Management Information Systems in 1997. He owns Messam Construction, which builds and manages green construction projects and provides construction management services. In 2011, Messam was elected to the City of Miramar Commission and is mayor of Miramar, Florida in 2015. It's a city of about 150,000, 20 miles north of Miami, and Miramar is home to more Fortune 500 companies than any city in South Florida. Messam is a deacon at the Fountain Church in Miami Gardens. He's married and has three children in college.
Mayor Messam, thanks for joining us on Conversation with the Candidate. We appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
So close to two dozen Democratic candidates in this race right now. When someone comes to you and says, hey, who are you first, and why do you think you can win in this field, what do you point to in your experience and your background to try and convince them?
Well, you know, as a mayor of a very progressive city with one of the fastest growing economies in the country, I'm dealing with a lot of progressive issues in the city of Miramar, Florida, which is the 13th largest city in our state. I get an opportunity to talk to them about the leadership of mayors and how close we are to the people, our ability to touch and reach, as well as solve problems for our constituents. And as mayor of the city of Miramar, we've done some great things like we passed a living wage, we banned the box, you know, we're competing with China where companies are deciding to stay and grow in our city. These are real issues. I mean, we've brought over 5,000 jobs, to high-paying jobs to the city of Miramar since being mayor. And these are issues that are transferable to the national landscape. So obviously with a crowded field, voters are looking for individuals that, one, that they can relate to, those who have a track record of service, those who they see can who can beat Donald Trump, or perhaps even those who can have the ideas that serve or that can solve the challenges that they're facing in their everyday lives. So as a mayor, I'm looking forward to continuing to get my message out. And the more people that we meet, the more people that we see, the more people that are seeing the Wayne Messam for President campaign are more intrigued and want to learn more, and I'm excited about that.
So obviously there seems to be a demand for outsider candidates, and mayors are well positioned there because they have a foot in politics, but they're not entirely political. But when you get to the White House, you have to deal with foreign policy and obviously the military. So what's prepared you to be commander-in-chief?
Well, obviously, you know, being a mayor, we work in a nonpartisan environment, and Washington, as we know, is very partisan. And in fact, that's where the gridlock is. Everyone is in their corners. You know, as a mayor, we get a chance to see a varying of ideas, challenges, competing interests. And our job is to meet those needs in a way where we can bring people together. And that's what is needed in Washington. Someone who has the breadth of experience in terms of dealing with competing interests, competing views, to be able to focus on what matters the most. In terms of being the commander-in-chief, obviously that's the number one job for the presidency. Even when I announced my exploratory committee, the first action I took was to take a trip abroad, and I went to the Middle East. I went to Jerusalem as well as Ramallah. I went on my own. I did not go by any groups. I wanted to get a firsthand experience of that specific conflict, and it was a great experience. And meeting with the Israeli Ministry of Foreign Affairs, as well as with the Palestinian leaders, it gave me a perspective to be able to see these are the challenges that we have to face. And my goal would be to restore America as an honest broker abroad.
What impacts of climate change have you seen in Miramar, and what have you done about it?
Well, you know, in the city of Miramar, we're investing over $100 million in our infrastructure. You know, obviously Florida, the state of Florida, is ground zero for sea level rise. But climate change means more than just sea level rise. It means that you see the record-breaking fires in the west in California, as well as in the heartland where our farmers are having impacts to their crop production. So climate change is real. So investing in our infrastructure is the number one solution regardless in dealing with climate change. So whether it's us raising our streets so that we can deal with rising sea levels, or could it be a situation in fortifying our infrastructure so neighborhoods aren't flooding as much. Those are the specific solutions that we're bringing to the table, but it also has had some economic benefit as well, because when you put local people to work, working on infrastructure projects that is making us more resilient is a win-win.
One of your big ideas has been canceling student loan debt. I think that's about over $1 trillion. So
yes.
How do you pay for that?
Well, in my proposal, it states that we will pay for this by repealing or adjusting the tax cuts that President Trump gave to the large corporations and the richest of Americans that didn't necessarily find its way into to the pocketbooks of the American people. So in a combination of that, it will be used to eradicate or forgive the $1.5 trillion. But it's not just forgiving the student loans. It's actually an economic stimulus because we see our analysis states that it'll add $80 to $100 billion to the GDP. It will create upwards of $1.5 million jobs. To the economy, as well as free up about on average $400 per month for average everyday debt holders to be able to invest in their retirement, qualify for a mortgage to perhaps buy their first home, but it'll put it back into the economy.
All right, Mayor Messam, those were the easy questions out here. The town hall audience awaits.
Yes.
Coming up after the break, we'll bring our studio audience into this conversation. Stay with us.